Mr. President, we have a national emergency.
This is one of the things that we can shoot first and ask questions later. Normally you can't do that.
All of a sudden these trees started moving out of the way. They parted for me. And then I came out into this opening, and there where I saw Jesus Christ.
Back in 1927, an American socialist, Norman Thomas, six times candidate for president on the Socialist Party ticket, said the American people would never vote for socialism. But he said under the name of liberalism, the American people will adopt every fragment of the socialist program. Is more imminent.
James Madison, in 1788, speaking to the Virginia Convention, said, "Since the general civilization of mankind, I believe there are more instances of the abridgment of the freedom of the people by gradual and silent encroachment of those in power than by violent and sudden usurpations."
When men were free.
End Time Prophecy News with your host, W. Dean Shook, is on the air.
As Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately.
"Tell us,"
they said,
"when will this happen and what will be the sign of your coming and the end of the age?"
"You will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places. All these are the beginning of birth pains. For then there will be great distress, unequaled from the beginning of the world until now, and never to be equaled again. If those days had not been cut short, no one would survive. Immediately after the distress of those days, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from the sky, and the heavenly bodies will be shaken. At that time, the sign of the Son of Man will appear in the sky. When you see all of these things, you know that it is near, right at the door. Truly, I tell you, this generation will certainly not pass away until all these things have happened. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words never pass away. As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. They knew nothing about what would happen until the flood came and took them all away. That is how it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know on what day your Lord will come.
And thank you. Welcome to End Time Prophecy, news and current events. I am your humble host, William Shook. Thank you for being here. I appreciate it so very much. We're having a special simulcast tonight. That would be the Blog Talk Radio Network and the Spreaker Radio Network and our regular broadcast affiliates across this great country of ours. All of you folks in the UK and the Middle East, good morning to our troops who are just waking up. Hello to everybody in Australia, the Philippines. Welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining us. The clip I just played is the crux of our show tonight, is why is everybody ignoring these end-time prophecies? Do people not care? Matthew 24:10 says, "And then many will be offended, will betray one another. They will hate one another. Then many false prophets will rise and deceive many. Many, because lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold." Tonight we're going to talk about some of these end-time prophecies that have made history. History. Things that not only didn't happen in the past, but could not have happened in the past. Specific prophecies that are current events now. Let's look, but I want to share a little bit of news here first, because we have terrorists in Boston. We have explosions in Texas. We have a possible nuclear showdown with North Korea. The Middle East is a tinderbox just waiting to explode. There's volcanoes, Yellowstone Park, Iceland, earthquakes and sinkholes popping up in random places. Extreme weather, solar flares that batter this world right and left. Here in America, we have pop stars and politicians that are joining forces to showcase their incompetency by enacting these idiotic and illogical legislations. Let's face it, folks, we know we're in trouble when the administration's brain trust consists of actors and musicians. And you can bet that if you're a conservative politician and you get a parking ticket, you can believe that ABC, NBC, MSNBC, and CNN are going to be there to provide nonstop blow-by-blow coverage of that ticket. But if you're a Democratic politician and you get caught with an underage prostitute, you might as well be in the witness protection program for all the coverage you're going to see about it. There's senators and congressmen who are either through too many drugs or political correctness. Some of these people can't even string a simple sentence together. These are the same people that are in charge of writing the laws that the rest of us have to follow. I mean, let's face it here, folks. There's random mobs of violent teens that are robbing stores. They're beating up elderly people for fun. Mass murder abortion doctors with tales so gruesome it would make your hair on your neck stand on end. I'm talking about Kermit Gosnell snapping live babies' necks and just calling it a late-term abortion. Yet, for some reason, the media seems to be able to ignore this. Well, before we start our discussion, we're going to talk about the fig tree prophecy. We're going to talk about a cashless society and the mark of the beast. But before we do that, I want to talk about what happened in Watertown, Massachusetts. I was really amazed when I watched the news and seen the people on the street clapping and honking and had, you know, saying thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, what were they saying thank you for? Were they saying thank you for catching the guy, or were they saying thank you for lifting this martial law? Which is what this was. This was a de facto martial law. And we're going to talk about that in just a minute. I have to play some kudos to our sponsors. Please listen to these from our sponsors. We're going to come back and we're going to talk about whether or not this actually was martial law, because this is a new normal, a police state. And what they did was de facto martial law. They just called it a lockdown. I'm also going to give you some other news about these jihadists, which is what they were, that the mainstream media is never going to tell you. Right after this break.
You're listening to W. Dean Shook, End Time Prophecy News and Current Events. Stay tuned.
Professional identity thieves constantly search your information for vulnerabilities. At LifeLock, relentless protection of your identity is their primary mission. They help ensure that you stay ahead of identity thieves. LifeLock is first in the industry to offer proactive identity theft protection. They're level one compliant under the payment card industry data security standards. They have direct access to fraud resolution teams within their extensive network of lenders and service providers. They are experts through leadership with internationally recognized experts in privacy and security, technologies, fraud, and criminal methods. They also partnership with...
You can now hear our program on Stitcher Smart Radio. Stitcher allows you to listen to your favorite shows directly from your iPhone, Android phone, Kindle Fire, and more. It's on demand and on the go. Don't have Stitcher? Download it free today at Stitcher.com or in the App Store. You can now hear our program on Stitcher Smart Radio. Stitcher allows you to listen to your favorite shows directly from your iPhone, Android phone, Kindle Fire, and more. It's on demand and on the go. Don't have Stitcher? Download it free today at Stitcher.com or in the App Store. Stitcher Smart Radio, the smarter way to listen to radio.
Well, what's that love? Nice little glitch in the studio there. Things playing that aren't supposed to play. The one that is supposed to play didn't. Thank you so much for that. What a wonderful studio we have here. My goodness, I'm sorry about that. I'm not even going to attempt that again. We're going to go on with this discussion. And hopefully, when we play a sound clip, it's going to play in the future. That was ridiculous. I'd fire myself if I could. All right. So I want to talk a little bit about this new normal. The new normal is a police state. You know, and I seen a story on Natural News.